Hello and welcome to Encore, coming up in today's show. His installations have intrigued art lovers from Stockholm to Seoul. Monumental sculptures, architectural angles and immersive musical experiences have kept Xavier Villon at the forefront of contemporary art for years. Selected to represent France at the 57th Venice Biennale, the artist joins us in the studio to tell us more. Xavier Villon, thanks so much for joining us today. As a visual artist, you're very well known here in France, and it has been the case for a number of years. But let's just remind ourselves of some of your best known work. Now, there's one piece of work that's missing from that visual CV, and that's your latest project. It's going to be on show at the Venice Biennale. I know that it involves music, and I know that it's interactive. Can you tell us a bit more?
Yes, actually, it's a big working place that we're building right now, and it's a construction linked to architecture as much as it's linked to art, because it's a big art installation that people can get inside. It's like a cave, kind of, made of wood, but it's based on the architectural vocabulary of recording studios and recording devices and acoustic elements that are put together, built. Everything is made more or less of wood, and we've been working with an acoustician in order to achieve a proper recording studio. With the help of Nigel Guthrie, who is a producer for Radiohead, and he provided all the equipment, which is amazing.
So we can expect some beautiful sound quality there, I think.
Yes, we don't know. There's always a risk, but it's part of the game.
Okay, now the Biennale is subtitled this year. The theme is Vive Arte Vive, which is long live art in a way, I suppose. Do you think art is in danger? Do you think we have to protect it?
Yes, I think it's challenged and it's put in danger with some ideas that are too narrow. And I think being an artist involves to be relatively open and to have an accurate vision, not only on your self, but also on things that are happening abroad and on the situation of the world. So I think the far right and the extreme are putting us in danger. And we are a generation that is not so aware of it, because we have been lucky enough to be preserved. But we are potentially in danger. And not only the extreme right, but also the environmental questions are major. And I think we're not facing it properly.
So there's a sort of cultural resistance as well. Now, participating in this sort of show, something the size of the Venice Biennale, is very, very prestigious, representing your country. It's sort of the Olympics of the world of art. We actually asked specialist and curator André Magnan about whether art really has a nationality.
Every 2 years, you have an artist who represents his country. But even if he's representing his country, that doesn't mean it's a national art form. It doesn't matter if the artist is French, Belgian, American, or African. It's simply an opportunity to show your work to millions of visitors and professionals. Just because you're representing your country, that doesn't mean your work doesn't draw inspiration from all the cultures of the world.
Xavier, what about you? Do you think that your artwork references a particularly French tradition?
Yes, I do, because I think as a student I was living in Germany for 2 years and there I realized how French I was. you don't realize it when you're in your own country. But for example, in the music of the beginning of the last century, there is a French clarté of the music that was specific. But I don't think Debussy or Ravel couldn't get it from inside. But you can compare it to German music, for example, and then realize how specific it is. So it's the same with visual art. And I'm convinced I'm very French, especially from people that are not French. But I'm also convinced that I have a message or something that I can carry around with my work that is more universal.
Mm-hmm. Well, it's the United Nations of Art, the Venice Biennale, so mm-hmm. that will be appreciated. Now, as an artist, you're best known for sculpture and installation. And in recent years, other participants at the pavilion, the French pavilion in Venice, like Henri Sala, Céleste Boursier-Mougenot and Christian Boltanski, they've also done installations. Mm-hmm. Can we say that painting on canvas is finished now?
No, not at all. Mark Bradford from the U.S. Will make a pavilion that will, I guess, include painting since he's a painter. And I'm always amazed when I see a good painting. And it's like saying that literature disappearing because there is a series on TV. Mm. So everything can coexist, and it has importance, both painting and installation work or video media works also.
Okay, well, you've mentioned music, of course. Mm-hmm. This latest project, Merzbau Musical, sees you at the crossroads between art and music. You've also mixed architecture into your work as mm-hmm. well. Is there another domain that you'd like to explore, like dance or gastronomy? I don't know. Mm.
Actually, dance, I feel quite close, and I just made a short movie with Dimitri Chamblas and Marie-Agnès Gillot, who is Danseuse Étoile mm-hmm. at the Opéra de Paris. Very short movie that you can see online. And it's very interesting to me. The main thing is what people have in their mind or their imagination after seeing a piece of mine or an exhibition. But it's also the physical impact of art, which I experiment as a viewer. Because we still have in mind that we should split formal and what is more intellectual, for example, when practicing art is a living proof of the connection of both of it. It's like sensuality, or it's like dancing, it's like many the different area in our life that are connected. And nothing can be experimented without the brain. So for me, art is mainly talking to the brain and through the brain to the body.
Okay, well, we can look forward to some more collaborations, perhaps. Now, one of your best-known shows here in France was in 2009 at the Palace of Versailles, a very contemporary interpretation of the site's royal history. How do you think it changes the experience for a viewer to see your artwork in a site-specific scenario, or perhaps isolated in a white cube like a gallery?
Well, it's very interesting also both in public art and in art in specific place, very specific places like Venice or like Versailles, because it's more challenging because there is a kind of a competition with the environment. And if you deal with it only like a challenge, you can't success. So you need to accompany the place with your own art, and to achieve that you have to understand, especially in Venice or in Versailles, you have to understand the history of it and take like the stream of history and that may lead you to something more contemporary.
When I was at Versailles, I noticed that a lot of the visitors there didn't necessarily come to see the art. They'd come as tourists, as families, and they were encountering contemporary art almost by accident. Do you remember the first time you encountered art in a gallery or in a public space when you were a child?
Yes, I do, but I'm probably wrong, like many things I remember. I remember being in a show in Normandy as a kid with my parents that weren't especially interested in visual art, but more culture in general. And it was a show in a kind of a, I don't know, it's called a pigeonnier, a place where you have doves.
The pigeon house,
Pigeon house.
The dove house.
An old pigeon house, and with Vasarely paintings around. And I liked very much the combination of this hard edge, very visual paintings and very effective painting in this environment, and it was like actually a pre-vision of experiences like showing in Versailles.
Mm-hmm. Well, that was, yeah, perhaps inspired you. Now we're coming full circle back to music again. It's a recurring theme. In addition to Mastbal Musical, you've collaborated with musicians from AIR, and you've also drawn us our attention to a new project. It's called Mind Gamers. What can we expect from that?
Mind Gamers is a new band that that has been formed around Sébastien Tellier.
Mm-hmm.
And they released their first single, and it's coming soon, a new album. And I haven't heard it yet, but I only one song I know, but seems to be very exciting, and I'm always very anxious about what Sébastien can imagine with together with his friends, and anxious in a good way.
Okay, well, we'll leave you with a taste of the track Power of Power by Mind Gamers. Xavier Villon, thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
Your work will be on in Venice from May 13th until November 26th. Do remember to check out our website for more arts and culture. You can also keep up with Encore on social media. There's more news coming up on France 24 after this.